When you look around in a crowded space, it generally seems like there's an equal distribution of men and women. As a global population, however, we are not equally split. There are roughly 102 men for every 100 women on the planet, which strikes some people as unusual. Nature doesn't do anything randomly, so there must be some explanation. Is it evolution? Behavioral characteristics? Birth rate? As it turns out, the answer is related to all three. While the population ratio is 102 men to 100 women, the birth rate is actually 107 men for every 100 women. Now, the sex of any fetus is dependent on a number of factors, including the parent's health, occupation, age, race, behavioral habits, hormonal treatments, exposure to environmental toxins, stress, previous childbirth experiences, and the mother's ovulation cycle. By nature, male infants are more likely to suffer some sort of health issue or premature death. Newborn males are at a biological disadvantage in survival, as they are also more vulnerable to perinatal conditions and infectious diseases like respiratory infections and intestinal infections. As men age, they are more likely to develop serious health issues and engage in risky behavior. Additionally, throughout history, countless wars and conflicts end with a much greater loss of life for males. This has been true since the earliest days of our species' development, so it makes sense that nature has had to compensate. The remaining difference in the ratio can be explained by social and cultural traditions, such as abortions and gendercide, since males are more desired than females in some parts of the world. Son preference is highly prevalent in several countries in East Asia, South Asia, the Middle East, and North Africa. Sons are preferred, especially in agrarian economies, since they have a higher wage-earning capacity and can continue the family line. Discriminatory practices against girls, such as the dowry system, also contribute to this unfair presence for male children. Since prenatal sex determination became available in the 1980s, it has primarily contributed to imbalances in the sex ratio in the form of sex-selective abortion. After birth, discrimination against daughters leads to neglect of their nutrition and healthcare requirements, resulting in higher female mortality. Unequal access to healthcare, especially in cases where the healthcare costs must be borne by the family, is the most important contributing factor towards female mortality. While there are more men than women from a global perspective, when you look at different demographics and geographic locations, the balance is often flipped. As you move up the age scale, particularly past the age of 60, there is a clear advantage for women, who tend to have longer life expectancies than men. The global average life expectancy for women is 71.1 years. For men around the world, life expectancy averages 67 years. In terms of geographical location, some countries in the Middle East have more than 250 men per 100 women. At the other extreme, the Caribbean island of Martinique has a ratio of 85 men for every 100 women. As always, natural selection has had a hand in keeping the battle of the sexes relatively even. In theory, all population dynamics should move towards a 50-50 split, but humans are a complex example, which is why nature has to compensate in various ways.